I wanted to make a video with all the new RGBA updates, starting with Mikey Garcia, 39-0, has a fight scheduled for March 16th in Arlington, Texas at the AT&T Stadium, 14 weeks before fight date. He's been seen in the gym training. Today, via ES News, Robert, his brother, his trainer, asked Josecito if he saw Mikey running today, and Josecito confirmed that he was on a run today. Josecito Lopez, 39-7, has officially moved into Mikey's 11-acre ranch to seclude himself for this camp versus Keith 110 Thurman. It sounds like his fighting partners in RGBA are Lindolfo Delgado and Misael El Chino Rodriguez. We have no updates on Bam Bam Rios. We know he signed a three-fight deal with DAZN, which he already won the first of earlier this year in Mulvane, Kansas. But we have no news or updates of the next fight for him out of that three-deal package with DAZN. Abner Martinez, we continue to see Abner in the gym in Riverside. Today, ends a bad joke with Robert. If the fight will be announced soon between him and Tank Davis. But we do not have an official fight announcement for Abner Martinez and Gervonta Tank Davis as of now. Jose Carlos Ramirez, no official announcement. His manager posted some news to be announced soon last week, but we don't have an update. Esquiva Falcao has a fight date of February 15th, 2019 for a title fight. 22-0 with 15 knockout. He posted this on his Instagram account. Eric De Leon has not been seen in the gym, and there is no fight news for him. He did have an injury in his second fight in 2018. It sounds like he's co-managed by Robert Garcia, and he might not train out of RGBA Riverside. He might train where he's from in Detroit, Michigan. Joshua and Professor Franco, 14-1-1. Sounds like his next fight date is January 26th. Robert mentioned that it's most likely going to be in Houston, Texas. There's talks of Chepe going to Josecito Lopez fight, which is on the same day, and maybe Pita going to Joshua's fight, or vice versa. Hector El Finito Tanahara Jr. improved to 16-0 this Saturday against a tough and dangerous fighter at the Fantasy Springs Casino in India. This was his first 10-round fight. He was dropped once during the fight, but managed to get a decision his way versus Phoenix, Arizona's Robert Manzanares. Jonathan Thunder Navarro from East LA also improved to 16-0 at the same card with Hector Tanahara at the Fantasy Springs Casino, against Manuel La Tormenta Mendez, who's 16-3-3 from Indio. Both of Jonathan's eardrums were damaged, one during training and one during the fight. It was a tough fight for Jonathan. Carlos Mexicanito Licona and the new IBF strawweight champion as of December 1st on the Wilder Fury card. His sister, if there's rumors that his sister, Lena Cookie Licona, could be on the Prospects Collide card in San Bernardino. Virgil Ortiz Jr., 11-0 with 11 knockouts, flew out to New York this week. He's going to fight on the Canelo Fielding Golden Boy Promotions card. On BoxRec, his opponent has been announced, Omar Tienda, 19 wins, 5 losses, from Guadalupe, Nuevo León, Mexico. Joseph Blessed Hand Adorno, who just won in Puerto Rico, tweeted out today. He didn't write a description. All he did was write 3/23/2019, which leads us to believe that that's his next fight date. Somebody replied on his tweet that Terrence Crawford's next fight date as well, and Adorno replied with an emoji. fish symbol over its mouth. So that's good news. That's a good card for Joseph to show off his skills on a big card like Crawford's. Alejandro Porchat Guerrero. Multiple mentions on PS News by Robert De Garcia that Alejandro will be fighting in December. My best guess is that he's going to be on the PBC Charlo fight card on December 22nd in Houston. But as of today, he's not listed on BoxRec on the fight card. Luis Coria, 9-2-0. I have a typo on his record. He's going to be the main event headliner scheduled for Friday, January 18th. 2019 in San Bernardino, and La Garcia Promotions card, Prospects Collide. Genaro El Conde Gámez, 8-0 with 5 knockouts from San Diego. It's rumored that he is on the card with Joshua Franco in Houston, in Texas, on that January 26th date for 2019. Misael El Chino Rodriguez, 8-0 with 4 knockouts, has been seen back in the gym multiple times. It seems like Misael might be living in the area. Today Misael said he's got a fight lined up in January in LA, in Los Angeles. So more details to follow on Misael and Chino Rodriguez, promoted by Ringstar, Richard Schaefer's Ringstar Sports. Rodolfo Delgado, 7-0 with 7 knockouts, has a fight date for Sunday, January 13th on FS1. His opponent has not been listed yet. We have no fight news on Brandon Bulletproof Glanton, who's 7-0 with 6 knockouts. Jesse Van Rodriguez just got a win on a 6-round fight, December 1st on the Wilder Fury card. Had a total of 4 fights this year. Brian Lua has not been seen in the gym, and we have no updates on him. 5-0 with 2 knockouts. This is a fighter for top rank. Isidro Choa, fights at 122, has been seen in the gym sparring Luis Coria in preparation for January 18th, 2019, and the prospect of Live by Garcia Promotions in San Bernardino. He just posted a picture in the gym with WBC champ Jose Carlos Ramirez, RGBA Riverside. Isidro Choa, undefeated 6-0. Aaron Morales just recently fought in the top ranked card in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Probably off for the rest of the year. He pro debuted this year and had a total of 5 fights in his first year as a professional. Brandon B. Fly Macias, 3-0 with 2 knockouts. He's scheduled to fight on January 18th on the Prospects Collide. He's been seen in the gym, he's been seen running, staying in shape. Robert Biggie Rodriguez from Texas, 2-0. No updates, has not been seen in the gym. Isaac Kalunga from Corona, California. Is scheduled to fight also on January 18th on the Prospects Collide card. And he's got a sparring partner in Luis Coria. Raymond Danger Murataya from Fontana, California. 5-0 with 3 knockouts. Not been seen in the gym, but he's got a fight lined up January 18th on the Prospects Collide card. Armin Reisbeck, 5-0 with 4 knockouts. The southpaw. It sounds, based on the ES News video, it sounds like the fighter has already been pulled off from the event, but added to the event might be Lena Cookie Iconas. So, Joseph Bonas, 4-0 with 4 knockouts. We have not heard any more from him. We heard that he was on the phone with Robert Garcia and he wanted to come back and train, but we have not heard anything from Joseph Bonas. No news on Manuel Flores from Coachella, 7-0 with 5 knockouts. Hopefully he gets thrown on the January 18th Prospects Collide card. That would be a good opportunity for him. Alexis Macizo Espino. Today we saw him on ES News. Originally his pro debut was going to be set up to be in New York this weekend, but it sounds like he'll be turning pro in England instead of the United States. He was seen in the fighter's house at RGBA Riverside today. Ruben Rodriguez from India has been seen a lot in the gym. He's scheduled to fight January 18th. Josue the Prodigy Vargas just won his fight last Saturday by a 5th round TKO in New York. So he improves to 12-1-0 with 8 knockouts. And then there's been rumors of Jeremy Adorno, Joseph's little brother, who fights at 122, might be joining RGB in Riverside. So that's good news for Adorno. Thank you for watching. More videos coming soon. From Suntail Media, you can follow me at Suntail_media on Twitter and Suntail Media on Instagram.